Thanks so much, Will. Well, the wedding day is, of course, a big event, but did you know that the stationery can help set the tone? Joining us this morning to share some tips and trends for wedding stationery is Stephen Levy, the owner of Crosstown Press. Good morning, Stephen.
Good morning, Megan.
Thanks for being here,
and
you brought a big collection of stationery with you. But before we get to that, I just kind of want to touch on the fact that you've been around since 1948, your family-run business.
Yes.
And as we know, the wedding industry has changed so much in those years, including wedding invitations. Things have gone to electronic, and more people are doing it themselves at home. Tell us about how your business has changed and how you've kept up with it.
Well, we've been doing this a long time. Moms and dads used to plan the whole wedding. It wasn't the bride. Sometimes we never even saw the bride. But today, brides are different. They're older. They're on their computers all night long, coming up with ideas. And now, instead of just being printers, we're more like facilitators. People come in, they give us their ideas, ripped out pages from the magazines, printouts from their computers. And we do all the printing on the premises. Everything is done right there. We've been in business for so long. We do embossing, we do thermography, letterpress, offset printing. Everything is done right there. So people can come in with their ideas, and we can make their dreams into a reality.
Okay, so they can bring in their ideas. And for everybody at home, too, when you say that you print them actually in-house, that cuts the middleman out, and that makes the price a little bit offset.
Oh, absolutely.
So let's look at some of these designs, too. And I know that there was one down here that you said was a little less money. So starting with this one, was there anything special on here? Because it feels special.
Sure. This one right here is thermography. And we came up with an idea because pockets seem to be a real trend right now.
Yes.
And we came up with an idea, which I have not seen anywhere, of slitting the back and being able to pick your cards right out of the invitation. Love the idea. And it's really taken on.
And everything is just in one spot.
All in one spot without having the large of pocket
and then
folder.
Moving on to this one, it's almost like it was inspired by a dress.
I can't believe that you said that, Megan. It was. This bride brought in a piece of her, a piece of the dress, and it was in lace. And then because we have a complete art department, we took the lace and made it into one color and put it as her invitation.
Well, so there you go. You can kind of, like you were saying, get the magazines, bring it to you. And I just want to get to this one really quick.
Oh, love
you were
that.
Saying this is letterpress, and
letterpress.
It feels amazing. It just has like a lift to it.
Well, letterpress is sort of funny because it's the real trend right now. Everybody wants letterpress.
Mm-hmm.
Brides will call, grooms will even call.
And it can be expensive.
Letterpress can be expensive, but it doesn't have to be. We do the letterpress on the premises. We've been in business so long. The machine that we use, that we do letterpress on, I think was purchased in 1955. I think it was our first machine, where a lot of places just took and broke their machines up when nobody wanted letterpress. The saying was, letterpress was dead. It is alive and well.
Well, it came back, and it came back big.
Big.
And a lot, too, for the vintage-inspired weddings, which we know is huge. Well, Stephen, thank you so much for coming on. And we're going to post a link to Crosstown Press on our website, and you can get to meet them yourself at City Bride this Thursday night. Whoops, I told you I was going to flip this over. And that's a free event, so you can register for it now at WPRI.com.